This is the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. Ludlow Show brought to you in part by AirTran Airlines. It's something else. By Taylor Construction Company. Call them and never paint again. By John Bleakley Winnebago, America's number one Winnebago dealer for 1997. And by the Blue Willow Inn. Gracious hospitality and superb southern food. The toll-free lines are now open at 1-800-572-TALK. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. We are glad you are with on an absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous December morning. Had some nasty weather over the weekend. Boy, it didn't stop. It seemed like it was raining everywhere my travels took me this weekend. And just kind of was afraid I was going to mildew. Wet getting in and out of the car, wet sitting around. But it's better today, and we're talking about a number of things. And we even talked a little bit about they're going to make a new Wonder Woman movie, hoping, I guess it's a made-for-television movie, hoping that they can develop this into a series. This is being done by the same folks who produced Lois and Clark, and a national search is on, they say. So if you've got any suggestions for a Wonder Woman, they'd love to hear from you. Also talk some about Indian reservations and how they work, and I'm not sure I understand the theory behind all of those. I know that from what I hear, they're doing better now thanks to some of these casinos they've been able to put up, but still a lot of poverty. And I have a lot of questions about that. In any event, we'll cover all of that or almost anything that's on your mind. Here's the way you get involved, 1-800-572-8255. That's 1-800-572-TALK. We're going to get right back to the phones and go to Madison, Georgia, and talk to the more than wonderful Radio Ray. What do you say, big boy?
Well, good morning.
With this cold weather, your eyes turn northward to the slopes, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
I know.
I'm just ready to go down, go up to the mountains and start, you know, snow skiing now.
Waxing the old skis?
Yeah, waxing them and putting special liquid on it so whenever snow hits the skis, and it slides off.
Yes, okay.
Yeah.
And it's on top of the skis.
Yeah.
Really dumb, isn't it?
And it's slicking the bottom of them, too.
All right.
Real slick, you know. Anyway, now I've been sitting here picking my brain for about the last hour, trying to figure out maybe to get some suggestions for the Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
Okay. Here's an idea. See what you think about this.
Okay.
Okay, I got to thinking, maybe why don't all of the women, all of the WACOs, think about maybe going to apply for the Wonder Woman position there?
Well,
let's look at it this way. We've got a lot of great women who listen to your show.
Oh, you mean just the women?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
You threw me off there for a minute.
Yeah, just the women, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, the WACO Club women.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. What do you think about that?
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Well, see, you know, like the cleaning lady, for instance, she'll be a good one.
Oh, just go leave a picture off at a Warner Brothers
store.
Well, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
I'll go with that.
Okay, good.
I'll go with that.
So that was my only thought I could come up with. And also, another one that could maybe, that would look great for the Wonder Woman would be Kim Basinger from Athens, Georgia.
Yeah.
Very, very famous movie star.
She would make a Wonder Woman.
And also, what do you think about this one? Julia Roberts.
Another good one, yeah.
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 Yeah, see, I got good taste, don't I?
You really do. You really do. For a guy that, yeah, you got good taste. I don't know much about Wonder Woman. I never saw the series, and I never read the comic books. I know that she's got an invisible airplane, that kind of stuff. But
yeah.
I don't know a whole lot about Wonder Woman, like I know a lot about.
And she was pretty tough too on television.
Oh yeah, she'd fist fight you.
I mean, wouldn't you have to be the one had to get her mad and let her sling you around?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she'd be tougher than Dr. Laura.
There you go, exactly. So that's all I wanted to talk about.
Well, I am glad that you checked in here with us, and I hope you'll do this on a frequent basis.
Well, I will. I'll be more than happy to.
We'll be looking forward to hearing from you. You take care.
Well, hopefully I will talk to you before Christmas.
Oh, certainly.
Okay.
Take care.
Have a great day.
Radio Rake, of course you'll talk to me before Christmas. That's a given. 1-800-572-8255 is our number, Ludlow and Denny. And boy, we are having fun. Now listen, Airtran Airlines has a present for you just in time for last minute holiday travel. It's a fair sale with no advance purchase required. None.
My guest in the studio this morning, Mayor and Chair of Athens, Clark County, Guanaloni. John Barrow, Commissioner, District 4, is on the John Breffel Show. Scott Berry, Sheriff out in Macona County. Superior Court Judge Lawton Stevens. Tom Chastain, as we continue our march through the commissioners.
Listening to Athens and Northeast Georgia, the John Breffel Show. Weekdays 9 to 10 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Hi, gang, this is Ludlow Porch, and if you're not listening to the Fun Seekers Network, just see what you're missing. Join me weekdays, 10 to noon, on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. Now, 1-800-572-8255, Caliph, Inman, South Carolina. Hello, old friend. How you doing?
Good morning. How are you, Ludlow?
I am great. Always nice to hear your soprano voice on the air here.
You always embarrass me.
Got a great voice. Ought to be in radio.
Oh, thank you kindly. I wanted to talk to you about Beyond Stupid.
Okay.
I had a couple of these good old South Carolina rednecks go in to apply for a job. And they had to take a test. And they're sitting down there at the table writing the answers and so forth. Number 12, Bubba, he reads and leans over and he says, "What's the answer to number 12? And he says, "Man, that's FOM." He says, "Huh? He's FOM. What's that?" He says, "FOM, you know, like an old McDonald's." "Oh, FOM, okay." He says, "How do you spell that?" He says, "Man, you is so dumb. It's E-I-E-I-O. Now, that is beyond stupid.
That is. That is indeed. You ready for Christmas?
I am ready for Christmas, you betcha.
All right. Got all your shopping done?
All of it's done.
I'm so proud of you.
And all of my cards are mailed, and I've even started getting cards in.
Oh, listen, we get a lot of cards. I'm not sure mine are mailed yet.
Oh, I got them mailed.
Oh, I'm proud of you.
I tell you, I'm just happy, and I got my windows all decorated.
When do you normally start your Christmas shopping?
When do I start Christmas shopping?
Yeah.
I don't know, around the first of the month.
First of December, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Because my mother used to take great pride in having her shopping finished and wrapped by the end of August.
Yeah, I'm too much of a kid. I can't wait that long.
Well, it's a great time of the year. It is. You talking about peace on earth, goodwill toward men? I think a lot of folks get that feeling, and I think it makes the world a better place to live.
It's really true.
Yeah.
It is really true. We've got a little Christmas play coming up this Saturday at the church, and I'm looking forward to that. You're going to be here when? A week from Wednesday?
You're talking about Spartanburg.
Yeah.
Somebody said, and I haven't checked my calendar yet because I don't have it right here in front of me. Somebody said it's Monday evening, a week from today at the Pick a Book in Spartanburg. I think it's at 5 o'clock.
Well, good. I need to buy a couple more books. You're going to bring some along, aren't you?
Oh, that's a bookstore. I hope they'll have some.
All right.
All right, my man, you take care of yourself. Look forward to seeing you when I get there.
Thank you, Ludlow.
Take care, buddy.
You have a good day.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. No last-minute stuff for Caliph. Already cards mailed. A lot of little things to do this time of year. A lot of little things to do. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. You just could not ask for much prettier weather today. If you're going to be out, you might want to wrap up good, because I'm not sure what the temperature is right now, but I know it's only going to 40. Well, that was the last word I had, that it's only going to 40. Now, this Wednesday, the 17th, I'm going to be in beautiful Brunswick, noon till 2 o'clock, at the Bookshop, Inc. That's on, you know where that is if you live down there. That's on Newcastle Street, 1519. With some of the best folks that I know, and we're going to be looking forward to having you show up there with us. That's Brunswick, this Wednesday, the 17th, noon till 2 o'clock, the Bookshop, Inc., 1519 Newcastle Street. We'll be there having the time of our life and meeting a lot of good folks. And another thanks to all the folks in Albany. Came by Lowell's Bookstore down there. What a great bookstore that one is, too. One of the real, real bonuses of writing a book.
Best and closest friend wandering through the days we thought would never end. It was back when I'd still get things from Santa Claus, back when he believed in me and overlooked the flaws that can grow inside until it hides the perfect little boy inside the man. I'm not a kid anymore.
1-800-572-8255. Hollis, North Carolina. And his honor, the mayor. Good morning, old friend.
Shalom, sir.
How you doing, big boy?
Yeah, I'm just absolutely wonderful.
Good, good.
Hey, I'm the guy that smiles a lot, so you can trust me.
Uh-huh.
Anything I tell you, you can believe it.
The smiling bandit.
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, they're gonna redo Barbie, you know.
Yes, a makeover, yeah.
To bring her up to political correctness.
Mm-hmm.
I got the answer.
What's that?
Combination of Rosie O'Donnell and Barbara Streisand. If that don't fit them all.
All right, somewhere in the middle of those two, you mean?
That's about as ugly as you can get.
Okay.
I have the answer for the Wonder Woman.
All right.
Composite Donna Shalala, Madam Madeline Albright, and Janet Reno, and Hillary. Put them all together, and wouldn't you wonder?
You know, I wonder where that name came from, Wonder Woman. I guess just two W's. I can't imagine why they called her that.
Well, the way she can fight on the street, you wonder if she's a woman, I guess.
Yeah, but she only fights evil.
But she has them magic bracelets.
That's so you can't shoot her. She'd be a fool to start a fist fight without magic bracelets.
Well, happy Hanukkah to you, and hang in there, man.
All right, big boy, I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah, she'd be just think about having the reflexes to see the bullet coming. Wow. John Bleakley Winnebago, America's number one Winnebago dealer for 1997. Let's go to George in Marietta. Hello, George.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Good morning, sir. How you doing?
Good morning, America. Listen, Ludlow, I think Wonder Woman should not be allowed to reappear on TV anymore. She's it's a too much of a violent show. It's not a good role model for our children.
Okay,
our children don't need to have violence.
But she's only violent with people who are violent with her.
Yeah, but the woman, the role model we should have is a woman, is a homekeeper. A woman should be at home taking care of the family as a role model. We don't need it. We have enough violence on TV and enough violence in America.
Well, how you feel about shows like Gunsmoke and some of those reruns that we get? Was it based on, even the titles based on violence?
Well, I think the parents should inform the children more about what to look at rather than the children just sitting down watching anything they want on TV at a young age. They have a young mind.
Well, George, the older shows that promoted good citizenship and healthy living, like
Ozzie and Harriet,
or Roy Rogers. There was a lot of violence, a lot of fist fights on the Roy Rogers show, but
there was very few shootings or that type of killing.
But it was based on Roy and Dale fighting evil.
Yes, but it was a lower volume of shock TV. Shock TV now has gotten out of control.
But you don't regard Wonder Woman as shock TV, do you?
Well, it shows a woman in violence, showing violence, and that's the wrong message we're sending there. That's just like sending a message to our children that condoms will overcome AIDS, which is a stupid statement out of Washington, D.C. Some of the silliest people live in Washington, D.C. They run the country. I mean, they're just like puppets on strings.
But you have to remember that Wonder Woman was set in the in a time when we had spies and that sort of thing in the 40s and the 30s, and it was always good against evil.
But when you put a woman on TV...
You don't think women ought to be against evil?
Well, when you put a woman on TV showing her masculinity, you're showing a type of a gay lifestyle.
Oh, come on now.
That's an abomination on Jesus Christ, too.
George, how would you ever connect Wonder Woman up with anything like that?
I've never seen a feminine woman have a fist fight in the open. Only the...
Well, I've never seen one fly in an invisible airplane. This is fantasy land, George.
Yeah, but you got to remember, the people in Hollywood have twisted minds when they write up these TV shows. Their way of life is completely different than ours. They have twisted minds. If I would go to Hollywood and tell them that Jesus Christ was still alive, they would say I was a nut. And I'd say, yeah, I'm a nut, but I'm screwed on the right bolt. Jesus Christ, the living God. That's what I would tell them.
All right, George, you take care of yourself.
Thank you.
1-800-572-8. He just equated Wonder Woman with everything bad. And I don't think he was. I don't think he was. And let's face it. Ozzie Nelson never had to fight spies. 1-800-572-8255, Ludlow and Diddy, and you are listening to the Fun Seekers Radio Network on a bright, beautiful, crispy, cold December day. You stay with us.
David on his silver vest. He was mean and nasty right clear through, which was kind of weird because he was yellow too. They called him Irving. Big Irving. Big Short Irving. Big Short Fat Irving. The 142nd fastest gun in the West.
All right. Then you know what you get when you... When you take away Wonder Woman's magic bracelets and her invisible airplane and the magic lasso that she had and her costume, Johnny Mathis. 1-800-572-8255, Cleveland, Tennessee, and Dougy Wuggy on the radio.
Oy vey, Luddy.
Hello there, big boy.
It's a wonderful morning.
It is a great day.
Bright and clear.
Yes.
Well, you know, I just don't think that there is anyone out there who can live up to the standard that Linda Carter has set for Wonder Woman.
Really?
Yes. I think it would be sort of a little bit like trying to look at a James Bond movie and pretend that Sean Connery is still doing it.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah, I'm not sure I ever saw that show. I guess maybe I did, but I can't remember it if I did.
Well, I think that they should abandon that project and fire right into something that'll have a little bit more impact.
Like what?
Wonder Wimp. Armed with, you know, magic golden muffins and the mystical, invisible push-and-go scooter. I think that would...
Who could we cast in that role?
I've got right on... I know I can think about it.
Yeah.
I know I can think of it.
Yeah, think
just
about
give me
it.
A minute.
Yeah.
Hey, Fun Bunny.
and you see, the muffins incapacitate them.
Yeah.
By making them double over with giggling laughter.
I think the voice would do that too.
By itself.
Yeah.
Okay.
Eat that muffin, punk. Make my casserole.
Here, hold this casserole. Boom. Fop.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I have discovered something.
And don't forget Keith, the boy wonder. We're on to something here, Doug.
Yeah.
Narrated by Lukewarm.
Here, put these slippers on. I'm taking you to jail.
You arrest him on a 104. That's ugly shower cap.
If you try to run... We'll put you in the pool until it freezes.
That's exactly right. That's funny stuff.
Well, you know, I have discovered something.
What's that?
Apparently, the right side of my brain is way behind the left side. Because when I put my phone on my other ear and leave the radio on, it sounds just right.
Yeah.
I don't understand that.
You're slipping a cog somewhere.
I think it must be. Well, I'm glad I discovered that, because I had been listening to the phone with my right ear, and now that I switched it over to the left ear, I can leave the radio on all the while.
Don't say that. We've been telling...
You've spent years trying to get people to turn the radio off.
We've been telling people for many, many years, turn your radio off so you can't hear it. And they don't do it.
Well, around Christmas... you know what?
What?
Now, we forgot... I couldn't call in because I was busy moving. But we should take this time of the year so that Denny can give thanks for having a job all these many years when otherwise he would have gone totally unemployed. Don't you think?
A little Thanksgiving time.
Yeah.
How about me? See, if I get too testy with Denny, he's going to point that out to me. That without him, you're sitting there looking at your radio going, what?
What? listening to Fluffy.
Yeah, exactly. All right, big boy.
I'm out of here.
You take care of your bad
self. I'm having way too much fun.
Talk to you soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Paclette, South Carolina, and Jack on the radio. Hello, Jack.
What do you say, Ludlow?
I don't know it, buddy. How about you?
Well, I know that you're my favorite radio personality.
Bless you.
And I have been, well, since I retired, I listen to you daily and enjoy your program for the most part, all of them.
Well, thank you, buddy.
But there's a thing that popped in my mind when you mentioned somebody for Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
To me, I've never seen it but once or twice, but there is a television program that has a lady, I don't even know her name, but it's Xena. Some kind of a...
Yeah, kind of like those Hercules movies.
Yeah, Yeah, with the Hercules series.
Yeah.
That, and she has a... there's another woman that sometimes is her sidekick or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
But either one of those, I think, would be absolutely perfect.
I don't think I've ever seen anything but the promos for those. I don't think I've ever seen that.
Oh, well, both of them are beautiful, beautiful women. They're extremely athletic and whatnot. I just feel like that they would be, either one of them would be perfect for Wonder Woman.
Well, they may be in the race here. You know, they are people already in the business and know how to act and that sort of thing. You might have hit upon what's going to happen.
Well, I have only seen it a time or two, and I don't even know the woman's name. But to me, she would be a perfect Wonder Woman.
Let's see if somebody can call in and come up with a name. I'd like to know who it is.
I would, too. I would like to know.
All right, buddy. You have a great Christmas. I'll talk to you.
Hey, okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, buddy. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Listen, if you got an office lunch or an office dinner and you want to really show off, take the office crowd to the Blue Willow Inn in beautiful Social Circle, Georgia, and really, really get treated like somebody important. Great. North Carolina, and Joe on the radio. Joe had to go. Let's talk to my buddy G on the radio.
Supper
tonight. G.
Yeah, I thought that I'd do that.
G.
Salad, pasta, and something.
1-800-572-8255. When you get them back to back, that gang, you're just absolutely helpless. Our number 1-800-572-8255. You know what I'd like to see? What, the new television things? Not Wonder Woman. And that's, I'd like to see them go back to some of the Westerns and remake some of the Westerns. Now, it'd be very difficult to cast these things because, in my opinion, they were all cast perfectly. I don't know how you'd recast Gunsmoke or even Bonanza. But it would be, remember those things, Bonanza, the Next Generation? Just didn't play. But maybe they need to come out with some new Westerns. That's what I'd like to see. And of course, all you need is one hit. And they tried that with A Lonesome Dove, the series. Don't think that did very well. But there again, we were comparing that with the other ones. Let's try Joe and Murphy again. Joe, how about it this time?
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
Doing good.
I told you, yep. I was holding on, and the line went that blank, and then I redialed real quick.
All right. Well, I'm glad. Thank you.
Okay. How you doing this morning?
I'm doing great.
When's
thank you.
When's Dick Frymer going to be back?
You know, I don't know, a month or so. About every 6 weeks is
about
a general
six
rule.
Weeks. Well, I was calling to sound off. That man a while ago, he quoted Jesus Christ, and people wouldn't know him. Well, I know him, and he didn't make women second-class citizens. I have raised four children. I've worked in and out of the house on a public job and things like that. That kind of stirred me up. But you remember Tarzan and Long Ranger and Red Rider and
yeah.
Superman and Spider-Man? It didn't warp my mind, and I know it didn't warp a lot of others, and I love Wonder Woman with Linda Carter.
Yeah.
But now, I understand about violence, but you look at any of your daytime or nighttime shows, and you've got violence and sex and cussing and drugs, and I'm opposed to it, but let somebody that wants to be somebody special to do away with crime and somebody jumps on her.
There's an awful lot on television, as you just pointed out. That's offensive.
Uh-huh.
And you mix that with the fact that a lot of folks are looking to be offended. you know what I'm saying?
But what I've started to say, you know, he said a woman's place is in the kitchen at home. I disagree with that, because you take all the women out of our workforce, and what would we have? Chaos.
Exactly what you have.
But, hey, I realize everybody has an opinion, and, you know, and mine don't mean nothing except to me.
Well, that's the only one you're entitled to give, and I love it.
Oh, man, I appreciate your show, too, every day. I listen to it when I'm at work and at home, and so I work part-time, and so that's the reason Gene tells me I can put my foot in my mouth by just turning around.
Yeah, but can't we all? Can't we all?
Well, this is a good time for the holiday season, and we're supposed to have love and charity and understanding and forgiveness.
And a little, mix in a little tolerance with
that. Forgiveness and tolerance go along.
Yeah, going to help us all.
Yeah, it would. Wouldn't it be a wonderful place if everybody, if me included, you know, the old saying, oh, when you point anything at somebody else, you got four more pointing back at yourself.
You take care of your sweet self.
Thanks.
Talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
AirTran Airlines, gang, it's something else. 1-800-572-8255. Now we're going to see if G is through ordering lunch. Hello,
Lord, G. Lord, I'm so sorry. You can have me flail with a wet fork.
No, I don't think that'll be necessary, partner.
I apologize.
That's all right, buddy.
You know, speaking of feminine violence, I saw my 11-year-old son get decked by an 11-year-old girl one Christmas.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They have a right to violence, too, you know.
Sometimes.
Yeah. Beyond stupid, can I mention something about that?
Yeah.
I was in the Naval Reserve when I was a young man, and you had to take a 2-week cruise every year.
Mm-hmm.
And when you aboard ship, the ship's company assigned you the dirtiest jobs they can find, so they won't have to do it.
All the things they don't want to do, yeah, of course.
Really? And this seaman first, I was a seaman first, so this guy took me down into the bowels of the ship to a place called the paint locker.
Mm-hmm.
It was like a little hole 6x6x6 with a ladder down the middle. He gave me a chipping hammer and a wire brush. He said, you chip all the paint off the overhead, the bulkhead, and the deck. So I did, and he came back with a 5-gallon bucket of gray paint and a brush and a stick to stir it up with.
Mm-hmm.
I was going along pretty good, and I had to get up on the ladder to, you know, to get the bulkhead. And, I slipped and I fell, and my foot hit the stick, and I spilled 5 gallons of paint.
Oh.
Do you have any idea how deep 5 gallons of paint are in a small place like that?
Cover a large area.
So I got the guy to come back, and he looked at it, and he said, well, there's nothing you can do. He said, take a brush and dip it up off the deck and slap it on the walls, you know, on the bulkhead.
Mm-hmm.
But every time the ship would pitch and roll, it would make waves of paint and splatter it all over the walls. So he said, well, we can't leave it like that. He said, you have to chip it off again and paint it over again. So I spent 2 weeks down in that little hole.
Join the Navy and see the world.
And see the world. Oh, that was a stupid thing to do.
Well, all you need is 1 second of not paying attention, and it's done.
Absolutely. Yeah. I was really embarrassed, you know, and everybody was laughing at me, but I had to spend the whole 2 weeks down there.
Tell me you become an expert.
Yeah. I've got a word of advice for all of us men. I have found the secret to a happy marriage.
All right, tell me.
Keep your mouth shut and do as you're told.
There you go. I love, just like the Navy.
I like the Navy.
I'll talk to you, big boy. Got to run.
All right.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. More. Had that. Beverly in Blue Ridge. Hello, Beverly. How you doing?
Oh, Ludlow, I'm doing great.
Good.
I want to thank you for the lead for Blue Willow Inn. Last Saturday, I took 22 senior adults down there, and this past Saturday, I took 47 people. And we had the best time, and that food was too good.
I hope you told them we sent you.
No, sir, you know I didn't. I should have.
That's all right.
But
as long as you enjoyed yourself.
It was just absolutely wonderful, and I couldn't help but say thank you for providing us such a wonderful time. We went, after that, we went by the Life University lights, and if you haven't seen those, honey, you've missed it.
No,
they are gorgeous.
All right.
So I just wanted to say thanks for
what
a wonderful time.
Listen, I thank you, and the main thing is you enjoyed it, and I knew you would.
Right. Okay, Merry Christmas.
Okay, Merry Christmas to you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. Yeah, great, great place. Take a busload. Dalton, Georgia, and John on the radio. Hello, John.
Hello, Ludlow. How you doing this morning?
Doing good, bud. You okay?
I'm doing pretty good. It's the first time calling. I just want to say Merry Christmas to you and everything.
Well, thank you.
I can give you a suggestion for the Superwoman.
All right.
Olive oil.
Good one.
Hey, olive oil make a good one.
A good one. That, I don't guess that would offend anybody, would it?
Not wouldn't.
Somehow, you know, even when I was a little boy, I knew, looking at that thing and enjoying the Popeye comic strips and movies, I just knew that she was too ugly to fight over.
Ain't it the truth? Hey, I don't worry you watch television very much tonight in the mornings, you know?
I don't get to see much in the mornings,
no. You ought to see that Jerry Springer show this morning.
They had a fist fight or two, didn't they?
Oh, they had a few hair pullings and fist fights. And, you know, over one guy, you know, two women.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'll tell you, that's something else.
Yeah, I like it when they advertise on the, when you're just sitting there and suddenly on the screen says, you know, is your mother cheating on your father?
Yeah.
Call 1-800, whatever it is.
Ain't that something? That's a big put-on.
It's something. It is something, I guarantee. But you know what? It's just burning up the ratings.
That's all it is.
Yeah.
That's all it is.
All right, bud.
Hey, I won't get that number for that filter you've been talking about.
Okay, hold on here 1 second. It's going to take me about a second and a half to do it, because I ought have memorized it by now, but by golly, I hadn't.
Well, my wife's got allergies a lot. She coughs a lot at nighttime. I was going to see if that'll help her.
Yeah, let me tell you something. This is good. This is really good, and I wouldn't tell you it was if it wasn't.
Yeah.
It's
1-800-724-0767.
Yeah, be sure and tell them I told you to call to get a 25% discount.
Okie dokie, Mr. Ludlow.
Wish you luck, my friend.
I enjoy it more, and I just had never called you. This is the first time, and I thought I'd call you and wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Glad you're here. Take care of yourself.
We'll call you later.
I hope so.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. Tyty, Georgia, and Mike on his truck phone. Hello, Mike.
Hi, Ludlow. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good, old friend. How you doing?
I'm doing just great. I just wanted to say that the guy that called earlier and was talking about how Wonder Woman promotes violence and all that, well, back when we were kids, we watched Popeye and Bugs Bunny and Elmer Fudd always trying to shoot him and beat him up and things. And, you know, I didn't turn out to be no criminal or nothing.
No.
So I think he just needs to lighten up a little bit, you know, and don't take life so seriously. I mean, these things are just for entertainment.
You know what I said? I said earlier, you're looking for something to be offended by. You don't have to go far. You can be offended by almost anything.
I mean, you don't have to. Just look at the end of your nose and you'll find it.
There you go.
I mean, I'm sure he. I mean, I don't mean to badmouth him, but I'm sure that he never offends anyone. You know.
Yeah.
It's just. I mean, I get out here ride around in this truck. I could be offended all day, but I just kind of take things easy and look for the good things, not the bad. You know, just, I guess the best advice is just lighten up a little.
That's good advice for anybody, Mike, and I appreciate it, buddy.
Okay, I'm about to lose you on this thing, so I really enjoy your show riding in the truck every day, and I just wanted to call and give my little 2 cents worth and wish you a happy holiday.
Okay.
You and Benny both.
I appreciate it, my friend. You take care of yourself, and you drive carefully out there, because a lot of them out there trying to get you. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Ludlow and Denny, and you are listening to the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
I'm waiting for you and the power you possess.
Come on.
This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens.
I don't know how to take this. it's really caught me off guard.
It's a wonderful compliment.
Oh, well, thank you, then.
you're more than welcome.
Well, that's nice of you to start off like that this morning with me. I was having a hard day.
It is the season to be jolly.
I was looking for an electric charcoal lighter. Have you ever used one of those?
Yeah.
Nobody's got them out right now. They're all in storage, I reckon, for the Christmas season or whatever.
Waiting till Christmas.
Says, I can order you one and get it for you in May or something. I said, well, that's going to be a little hard, you know, for a Christmas gift.
Yeah, tough.
But, was that what I called? What'd you call me for?
I don't think I called you.
Oh, okay.
See, I told you you were strange.
How about for Wonder Woman, Janet Reno?
Okay.
Don't you think she'd be a pretty good one?
Yeah. Yeah, that ain't bad.
She's pretty tough.
And she's a big old girl.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes you wonder. So it seems like you pitch it in three or four different ways.
All right. That's my nominee to go along with yours.
Did I tell you about the cartoon that I saw about, I can't remember if I did or not, that it was a Santa Claus?
No.
And he was making a list, you know, he was talking to Bill Clinton. He says, I got to find out who's been naughty or nice. And Janet Reno steps up. She says, here, I'll take care of that.
My department. My department.
Well, you know why we have Thanksgiving or turkey for Thanksgiving or Christmas?
Why?
Well, because it took too much stuffing for a buffalo.
See? Tell me that ain't strange.
Ponder that for a minute.
I'm pondering that. I did not reject it. I just said more evidence.
It was good to hear my old buddy George there a while ago.
I'm sure you enjoyed George.
I think I used to know him in Niagara Falls when I lived up there.
Yeah.
We had a lot of fun together.
I bet you did. I got to get out of here, big boy.
Well, look, I hope you have a big, what is it, 4th?
4th of July,
up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll talk to you soon.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
You see, he never denied being strange. He is strange. Wonderful, but strange. AutoSave car, truck, and van rental gang. Local folks with 6 Atlanta locations. 1-800-572-8255. As we talk to my buddy, Dr. Tom Cooper.
Hello. Hello there. How you doing?
I'm doing good, big boy. How you doing?
I'm fighting the battle against fat.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you winning or losing this time of the year?
Win a few, lose a few.
Yeah.
I've done research things in the past that are kind of fun to do that wind up not costing anybody anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got a such a deal for people.
Such a deal. What is it?
Well, there's this new material out that fools your brain into thinking you've got chocolate.
It's called whiskey.
No, that too. But no, this is it's called the chocolizer. And what it is a tablet that there's a chemical that's absorbed by your body when you eat chocolate. And what happens is the stuff goes to the brain and tells the brain cells up there that one receptor area, I call it the C spot, that you've gotten enough chocolate. And it fools the brain into thinking you've had the equivalent of 2 chocolate bars. And somebody who's a real chocolate addict, or for women who have that PMS craving for chocolate,
mm-hmm.
It works. And what I want to do
is...
You take a pill. It's an extract of cocoa, actually.
Okay. Can you hang on for me?
Yeah.
Because I'm coming up on a break, and I want to get everything down pat so we can all be chewing those wonderful chocolate pills. Hang on just a second.
Thank you.
We'll get back to Dr. Cooper and find out how you can be involved in this right after this. I want you to put down April 23rd to May 2nd on your calendar. Yes, sirree, because I'm going to take a group of the wackos to England and Scotland, and we're going to have the time of our lives. First class all the way. We're going to see Scotland the way it was meant to be seen. Once you on board, you call 1-800-906-4232. That's 1-800-906-4232. We're going to England and Scotland.
Your battery's dead.
Who are you?
The Battery Grim Reaper. I take dead batteries to their final resting place.
You're kidding.
No, pop the hood. I'm a busy man.
But it's not that old.
I gave you the warning signs.
You have to start. I'm late. Come on.
Well, you should have gone to Sears Auto Center and treated yourself to a diehard. Letting you off could get me demoted to Houseplant Reaper.
Diehard, huh?
And you'll never see me again. Unless, of course, I get the big promotion.
Diehard. Tried and true.
News Radio 960. The new WRFC gives you the latest information every 30 minutes with updates from Athens' largest broadcast news team. Extensive coverage of events that affect you most. In Athens, Northeast Georgia, the nation and the world.
This is reporter Mark Aylwine of ABC affiliate WRFC, Athens, Georgia.
Police are continuing their investigation and
your
charges
for reliable, frequent, informative news, weather, and sports. News Radio 960. The
And you'd do that about 6 days and then just report back to me what's going on.
You want them to call first or just
If they would, just give us a call. And the phone number is 770-952-7681. I'm going to do about 30 people. And
okay.
I have about 30 subjects. And that's about, if you don't have that many, it doesn't have any statistical meaning. So, for a study to be published in a medical journal, you got to have at least 30 participants.
Okay, so I'll just give you a call at seven. I'll get one of your folks, 770-952-7681.
Uh-huh.
And then that'll start the ball rolling.
That'll start the ball rolling, and it might be a little fun for them to try it and see what happens.
So I want you to give us the results now when you when you get it back.
I shall.
I want to hear about this. 770-952-7681. All right, bud.
Thank you.
Okay, Tom, take care now.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, thanks.
This is Juliet, Georgia, and Robert on the radio. Robert, how you doing?
Doing fine, Ludlow. How you doing?
Good, buddy, good.
Good. Yeah, I was just calling. Heard some of you listeners were wondering if we were still open down here. And, you know, we got in July of 94, we had a big flood and almost washed us out, but...
Now, tell about you talking about a particular business in Julian?
Yeah, I'm the co-owner of the Whistle Stop Cafe.
Okay, the business. the one that's been made famous by fried green tomatoes.
Yeah, that's the one. That was my daddy's old general merchandise store.
All right.
But we're still going, and of course, this month, a little bit slow, you know, with all the people doing the Christmas shopping in the malls and things, but... But we're still here and still have some shops open, and we just wanted to tell the folks to come down to visit and eat with us. And
what kind of shops y'all have down there?
Well, we have a variety of shops. We have an outlet for Havisham wine, and just some variety shops.
All right.
Candy shops, and but we're still open, just like people come by and see us.
All right, buddy. You take care of yourself.
Okay, we appreciate it.
Good to talk to you.
All right, good to talk to you.
Bye bye.
Goodbye.
1-800-572-8255 is our number. The inspector is here, walking out of the fog and into your heart. Hello, inspector.
Monsieur, you just say it so well, so eloquently.
How are you?
I am fine. Are you doing okay on this Monday morning?
Doing good.
That's good. Monsieur, I had a little training session with my men here last week, and I just wanted to report to you. As you know, I have the prestigious investigative firm of Sauté and Brannis, and so in an attempt to, how would you say, expand my portfolio?
Yes, very good.
So to speak.
Very good.
You know, I want to get into the BIM detection, Monsieur.
Into the BIM detection?
Yeah, for detecting the BIMs.
That's B-O-M-B, BIM?
Yes, B-O-M-B, BIMers.
Yes.
Yes. Anyway, you know, it used to be very easy to detect the BIM, you know, the little round black bar with the fuse sticking out, or the dynamite with the battery and the little clock is for the times BIMers.
Yes.
But, of course, everything going high-tech and the terrorist scallywags and scoundrels there are today, unfortunately, there's many high-tech explosives. So
yes.
It's more difficult to detect the dimmers.
Mm-hmm.
So I just sent my Minke to a special school, and I am pleased to report that I now have a BIM-sniffing Minke. So he can.
Well, I'd like to congratulate you both.
Thank you, thank you. And it's funny that I was calling you today, because a little while ago I had a knock on my door here at Sauté and Brown, and I went to the door, and there was a little man standing there with the black leather overcoat, the little black hat, black patch on one eye, scarred down the faces, holding the package, and he said, "Merry Christmas, Inspector."
Yeah, listen, you want to hang on and get through? Or you,
I can do.
All right,
I can do that.
Hang on, and we'll let you finish up about your bims. We'll be right back. You stay with us.
WRFC Athens, a Southern Broadcasting Company's radio station. This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Good morning, I'm Beth Larson with an information update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. 48 degrees at 11:30, the official three-day forecast is coming up. An Athens man is facing charges after exposing himself at a nightclub over the weekend. Authorities say 29-year-old Charles Lieber showed his penis to around 15 people at the Country Rock on Commerce Road. He's been charged with indecent exposure. A prosecutor in Northeast Georgia has offered to surrender his law license for 2 years. The state bar alleges that District Attorney Albert Taylor used money from a client's estate to pay for a $375 shopping trip. Taylor's judicial circuit includes Lumpkin, White, Union, and Towns counties. And gunfire from a sniper in some nearby woods has injured two students at an Arkansas high school. They're in stable condition at a hospital. Police say the students were in a parking lot before the start of classes when the shots were fired. They say the two teens may have been the specific targets of the gunman, who hasn't been caught. Checking stocks this hour, the Dow is up 35 points, NASDAQ down 17. News Radio 960, WRFC News Time, 11:31.
Embodied in the Pledge of Allegiance is hope for and trust in our nation. Daily, children come together with their dreams and recite this pledge. Navy volunteers recognize these same children as our future. This is why they tutor and encourage children in classrooms across America. Because given the importance of education, shouldn't we pledge our allegiance to America's students? Make your pledge to our children to join the men and women of the Navy who serve our country at home, in our communities, and on the high seas. Call 1-800-USA-NAVY. That's 1-800-USA-NAVY. Or visit the Navy's website at www.navyjobs.com. The United States Navy, serving America twice.
More with Ludlow Porch is just ahead, but first, the official three-day forecast from WRFC meteorologist Mark Tobin.
Mostly sunny this afternoon, a breeze at times and a high of 54 degrees. Then tonight, moonlit and cold, low near 30. Tomorrow and Wednesday will each feature more sunshine. It'll be milder with pleasant afternoons each day. High tomorrow near 60, Wednesday's high 62. I'm meteorologist Mark Tobin at the official three-day forecast on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Currently, fair skies and 48 degrees on South Millage Avenue in Athens. I'm Beth Larson, and you're up to date at 11:32. More news in less than 30 minutes and bulletins at once from News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Quickly to the inspector. Are you still there?
Monsieur?
Yes.
Monsieur, while I was on the hold, I had my Mickey sniff the package, and it exploded, monsieur. Can you please send us to help? I'm hanging from my ceiling fan.
Yeah, we'll send somebody with a step ladder.
By regard, no, do not turn on that wall switch. No. Monsieur, I've been ran to ran. I'm a scare.
Well, I'll see you later.
Please send help. Us.
Bye-bye. on the fan. Thomaston, Georgia, and Mattie on the radio. Hi, Mattie.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm fine, you.
Good.
I enjoy listening to your program every morning.
Thank you.
And this is what I want to share with you.
All right.
My brothers used to go swimming in the old Chunk Creek, as they call it.
Mm-hmm.
My brothers, cousins, and friends. So my mother was afraid for them to go, but she was telling them, say, if you go down there and get drowned and come back here, I'm going to whip you sure.
I love it.
And so I always remember that. We laugh about it often. We enjoy your show. Wish you a Merry Christmas.
Thank you. You take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
But that, Diddy, that's like the one, if you break your leg, don't come running to me. 1-800-572-8255 is our number as we talk to the pencil pusher in Albany, Georgia. Hello,
good
young
morning.
Lady. How you doing?
Well, I'm glad you and Miss Nancy had a safe trip back.
Oh, it was a mess.
Georgia.
It was a messy trip, but it
I
was safe.
It
yeah.
was.
Yeah.
Well, we enjoyed seeing you know, folks around. One lady, I had to chuckle. I went over to the counter to, you know, to pay for my book. And there were, you know, folks meeting around. This lady said, I wonder if any of the wackos came today. And I kind of grinned rather sheepishly, and I said, well, yes, ma'am, I'll admit to being one. Oh, who are you?
Oh, it's funny.
She said that I wonder if then I'd forgotten that Mac was, I'd been sitting talking to he and his wife for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I have a couple of beyond stupid.
All right.
It's an honest confession. The other one I saw in the paper the other day. In the newspaper, I read an account of a bank robber who was caught. He walked up to the window, you know, and handed the teller his note or made his demand at any rate.
Yeah.
And went hurrying out the door, left his wallet lying there.
Yeah, I read that.
Did you?
I read that.
With his ID.
That's wonderful.
A few years back, it was winter and cold and rainy and nasty, and I had gotten, thought I had a sinus infection, so I went to see my doctor. And Tom talked, asked me this and that, and he said, well, Patsy, I think you have you've got pneumonia. You're not a Baptist, but I think you have a touch of it. And he, and I still laugh about this, the idiotic statement I made, I said, oh, no, I don't have pneumonia. He leaned back in his chair and peered at me over and through his glass. He said, and why did you say that?
How did you diagnose that?
And I said, because I've never had it.
Well, that's funny.
We've thought about that every now and then. He said, do you think you have pneumonia again?
That is so funny.
I said, honest to Pete. You know, you think, jeepers, but Wonder Woman. I enjoyed just tremendously because I was an avid comic book reader and collector. That was our rainy day pastime. We'd get on somebody's porch.
Exactly.
With our stacks. But I could not believe this man wanting to equate Wonder Woman with the funny folks.
Yeah, well, he equated it with several things that were out of line.
I didn't get all of what he said because I was in the car and I thought, where is this man?
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
he didn't think women should be violent. And we all agree with that.
I agree with the man.
Well, when you dedicate your life to crime fighting.
Well, I wonder what he thinks of women who put their lives on the line every day as members of the police and the FBI.
Why didn't I ask him that?
Oh, I don't know, but if he calls back,
I will.
Whoever he is.
I will.
Well, you have a good one.
All right.
Y'all sent some sunshine down this way.
Oh, we got plenty today.
Well, we have a little bit occasionally.
Peeping in and out.
Peeping in and out. Just enough to say, hi, I'm here.
I enjoyed being with you the other day. We had a nice visit.
It was nice. The people at the store were very pleased. And now they know who wackos are.
Well, plus we
I hope.
You bought all the books. They like that.
Oh, yeah, they like that.
Not to mention me.
Well, it was nice seeing you and Miss Nancy.
We enjoyed it. You take care
take
of your sweet
care.
Self. Bye-bye. Yeah, sold all of the books in that store, which was wonderful. Now, I want to remind you that this Wednesday, the 17th, from noon till 2 o'clock, I will be in beautiful Hope Sunshine in Brunswick, Georgia, from 12 to 2. From 12 to 2 at the Bookshop, Inc. And if you live down there, you already know it's at 1519 Newcastle Street, one of the country's great bookstores, in my opinion, and we'd like for you to come on by and either pick up a copy of the book or just stick your head in the door and say hello. Either way will tickle me nearly about to death. That's Brunswick, Georgia, from noon till 2 at the Bookshop, Inc., 1519 Newcastle Street, and I'll be there this Wednesday at high noon. So make your plans now to come by and say hello. We would appreciate it. Our number here is 1-800-572-8255, and we are open, we are loose, and having a big time, and we'd like for you to jump in here. Been talking about Wonder Woman and almost anything else. You know what we might need to touch on one of these days? Your least favorite Christmas carol. Christmas song, I guess we should say. Because there's always some that you just hear too much of. We'll talk about that some. Listen, I want to tell you about my buddies, Taylor Construction Company. Just about the nicest folks I know. Been in the vinyl siding business for over 28 years. Thousands and thousands of satisfied customers. What I'd like for you to do, if you're tired of painting, if you want to make your house look brand new, is call these folks. I'll give you a number in just a minute. Call these folks. Let them come by and make an estimate. No high pressure ever. You're not going to have to worry about getting rid of these folks. They're good people, and I wouldn't put you through any of those high-pressure guys. So I want you to call them, let them come by, look at your house, measure it, tell you how much it's going to cost, and tell you how you can do this. 1-800-9-TAYLOR, T-A-Y-L-O-R, 1-800-9-TAYLOR. Or if you're in the greater Atlanta area, 770-587-3454, 770-587-3454. Good, honest, decent people who really want to make your house look brand new. You call them and never, ever paint again. Now is the time, gang, for you to jumpstart your Christmas spirits by visiting the Appalachian Lights at Burt's Farm in beautiful Dawsonville, Georgia. Over 500,000 lights, beautiful scenes, something for everybody in your family. Give them a call for full details and directions. 1-800-600-BURT. That's 1-800-600-BURT. See the beautiful Appalachian Lights at Burt's Farm. You'll never be sorry, and the children are really going to love this.
Come into Borders this holiday season.
Look at her. Mom's so sneaky.
What are you talking about?
I think she's getting our Christmas presents today.
Where you'll find thousands of books and videos.
Where is she now?
By the romance novel.
It's a decoy.
A huge selection of music.
Now she's listening to CDs to throw us off.
And lots of other great gift ideas.
Wait, what's that?
A bagel?
Ooh, she's good.
Or not. Give yourself a present. Spend a day exploring at Borders. Books, music, video, and a cafe. Come inside.
Dr. Joy Brown.
Just amazing to me. Whenever a woman accuses a man of indecent sexual acts or rape or whatever, we blame the victim. We blame the woman. You shouldn't have been there. You shouldn't have been drinking. You shouldn't have been wearing those kind of clothes. It's kind of like when Tyson bit the Holyfield's ear. We didn't say, look, Holyfield, you shouldn't have been in the ring with him. Anything after the word no is rape. Period.
Dr. Joy Brown. Weekdays 1 to 4 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
That's it.
Hey, you listen for the Ludlow Porch Show weekdays 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
All right, let's do a Christmas song.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me some parts to a Mustang GT. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two hunting dogs and some parts to a Mustang GT. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 3 shotgun shells, 2 hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
All right, plenty
of
stuff. 1-800-572-8255 is our number as we go to Rome, Georgia. Talk to JJ. Hello, JJ.
Hi, Ludlow.
How you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good, good, so good.
Well, I want to speak about the man who called in and said Wonder Woman wasn't a good role model for women.
Right.
Okay. I was raised with a role model of Harriet Nelson and Beaver Cleaver's mother.
June.
The happy, submissive wife, housewife image. But I didn't marry an Ozzie Nelson or a Ward Cleaver.
Yeah.
I married a Jekyll and a Hyde man.
I got you.
So I really needed to have been more like Wonder Woman to protect myself and my children.
Yeah.
But I didn't know you could be that way.
Yeah, I understand.
So I think that if anybody needs a role model, it would be a man to be a good husband and a good father to his children.
I knew.
That's where the problem is with the men of this country, not the women.
Yeah, well, you of course, there's a lot of bad actors out there. I knew a lady one time who was raising her sons, and she would tell you straight out, I'm not raising anything except husbands.
that's where the world is going wrong. It's with the man because he was created first, and the submission he should have to God, and then his wife should be submissive to him. But if he's not submissive to God as his role model, then that's where the family's falling apart, and that's what's wrong with the country.
I'm glad you called. I hope you'll do it again.
Thank you.
Take care.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. Myers Carpets Gang, the oldest Mill Direct carpet store in the carpet capital of the world. Let's go to Cartersville now and talk to Lynn on the radio. Hello, Miss Lynn.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Good. You're on the air. Go right ahead.
Well, I got a story about my least favorite Christmas song
okay.
on the radio.
Okay.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
I don't.
You have heard that song. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. It is awful.
I can't remember hearing that.
Well, someone will give you pleasure now that I've brought it up.
Yeah.
But, I'm sure you've got listeners out there here. I've heard it twice this season on the radio.
Who does it? Do you know?
Oh, gosh. I don't even want to know. It is bad.
Really?
Uh-huh. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
I got to know what they had, how they rhymed something with hippopotamus.
I don't think they did.
Oh, that's funny.
But I have a friend of mine. Oh, he died about 2 years ago. You may have heard of him. His name was Jay Beatty, and he was a big name in Christian radio.
Mm-hmm.
Did a lot of announcing over the years. Well, he heard that I didn't like that song. I made that comment at a gathering once. Well, my Christmas present from him 2 years ago, he called my answering machine. he got a copy of that recording. He called my answering machine and played it. He was a great practical joker.
Oh, that's funny.
He played that song all the way through from start to finish on my answering machine. He had to call back 2 or 3 times to get it all of it.
That is funny. And that didn't help your hatred for that song either.
Oh, no.
I'm glad you called, Lynn.
I'll never hear it again without thinking about him.
Yeah. Take care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Frosty Mountain, pure spring water, gang. Water from the spring, not the tap. It's available at fine stores everywhere. Let's go to Griffin, Georgia, WHIE, and talk to my pal Fred. Hello, Fred.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you, old friend?
All right. You okay today?
Doing great.
Good, good. A couple of things getting behind that call earlier, but I didn't hang on to speak. I'd get that message to you about Lucy Lawless. Plays Xena.
Yeah.
And I'll have to admit, she'd make a good Wonder Woman. I'd thought of that at the top.
Now, that's the lady that's in one of those Hercules-type
right.
things?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she can turn flips, do some good things. Yeah, she's...
All right.
Her name is Lucy Lawless. And Hank Thompson did On a Hippopotamus for Christmas.
How long ago?
Wow, going back probably 15, maybe 20 years. It's still around. We got a 45 year somewhere stored away with it.
I wonder how in the world I miss that. I thought I heard every one.
It was there, but I'm glad you reminded me of it. I haven't seen it yet around, so I might maybe look for it. Maybe I'll bring it out and see what she's talking about. I can't remember exactly what was in it, but I'll have to listen to it. Now she got my curiosity up. It's been a while. But I just thought I'd fill you on a couple of things.
Well, I appreciate that because normally we just in a day-to-day living through the Christmas season, we think we hear all those things. Maybe not. That may be a sign I've been listening to too much talk radio.
Well, somebody had come in here this morning and looking over a CD, and there's something on there like coming in on a 747 and a redneck Christmas. I never heard the like in my life.
Mm-hmm. Well, everybody's hoping to be the next artist that comes out with Rudolph.
Yeah.
Or one like that, because then their financial woes are solved forevermore.
Yeah, they'll have to work hard on that one.
All right, big boy.
All right, good to talk to you, Lou.
Always fun. Thanks a million.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Anybody have the words to that? Dini, have you ever heard it? Nope. Well, that's good. Because I thought I was the Lone Ranger. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Ludlow and Denny, the Fun Seekers Radio Network. And we're pretty wide open today. We're not going to cull much today. We will. We started out by Wonder Woman, just because they're going to do that all over again. There must have been some kind of survey about that, because the show that they had on television only ran 2 years. And which, you know, I guess that's above the norm. But I wouldn't think that'd be enough evidence to want to redo it. But what they're hoping is they'll draw enough ratings on this movie and get enough reviews on the television movie to launch a new series, and that could make everybody rich. 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. You know, I've been telling you a long time about the allergy-free air filter. You know, less dust in your home, just the best furnace filter ever. Well, now they have really outdone themselves. They're out with the last word in an air filter. It's called AllerPure. It's twice as effective because it catches even more of the smaller allergy-causing particles. It's easier to clean, and boy, does it do the job. You can actually see the results. Less dusting. Now, some more good news. If you already own an allergy-free filter, they will deduct the price of your current filter from the cost of an AllerPure air filter. If you don't have one, you just tell them that I told you to call, and you get 25% off. Let me give you the number. 1-800-724-0767. That's 1-800-724-0767. You call these folks today, because I'm here to tell you, you owe this to your family. You call them today.
Local talk the way it's supposed to be. It's John Breffel.
My guest in the studio this morning, Mayor and Chair of Athens Clark County, Guinalooney. John Barrow, Commissioner, District 4, is on the John Breffel Show. Scott Berry, Sheriff out Macona County. Superior Court Judge Lawton Stevens. Tom Chasteen, as we continue our march through the commissioners.
Listening to Athens and Northeast Georgia, the John Breffel Show. Weekdays 9 to 10 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Spicy foods, pressure and stress. When they bring on heartburn and acid indigestion, you can reach for Tums, or you can reach for Rolaids. You should know that tablet for tablet, Rolaids can absorb 47% more acid than regular Tums. It's powerful, and it works fast. When you feel the burn of acid indigestion, remember, Rolaids, R-O-L-A-I-D-S, spells relief. Use as directed.
People write songs about downtown. Have you ever heard anybody sing about going to an outlet mall? And in Athens, we're especially proud of our downtown with its historic charm and architecture. But people come to downtown Athens for more than that. Did you know that downtown Athens has over 50 retail stores and the largest concentration of restaurants in North Georgia, serving everything from jambalaya to Thai food, from sushi to American hamburgers? We've got 2 parking decks and plenty of on-street parking, and most stores are open late and Sundays 1 to 5. We've got more bikes and bicycle shops, music, book, jewelry, and shoe stores, specialty apparel and gift shops, cafes, clubs, and eateries combined in the nearest mall and outlet center put together. But more importantly, we've got the ambiance and flavor of a European village and the warmth and personal service that's been the custom since they built this old town. Downtown Athens, the center of attention.
Hi, gang, this is Ludlow Porch, and if you're not listening to the Fun Seekers Network, just see what you're missing. Join me weekdays, 10 to noon, on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. Let's talk now to Roberta in White, Georgia. Hello, Roberta.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
This program has brought back a memory from years ago.
Good.
I was back in high school, and I finally got my courage up to go to a school dance with one of my girlfriends. We went stag, and this young man asked me to dance. Well, we danced and sat down, and he started talking about a car accident he had been in. And opened my mouth, and out came, "Did you die?" Oh, and I wanted to.
Oh, yeah, already nervous about the new boy.
Yeah.
And now you said something that's so outrageous that you can't believe it came out of your mouth.
No.
That is so funny.
I've never forgotten it. I'm
that
70
is so,
now.
So funny.
Oh, dear, but I've enjoyed your show.
How did he respond?
I can't remember that, but I know I didn't get another dance.
Oh, yeah, he spent the rest of the evening saying, "You see that girl over there?"
That's probably true.
I'm glad you called, Roberta.
Thank you.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Go to Noonan, Georgia. Talk to Dot. Hello, Dot. How you doing?
I'm fine, Ludlow. How are you?
Good. Thank you.
I've got part of the words, too. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
All
I don't
right.
remember everything, but I remember this song from when I was a small child, and I'm in my mid-50s, so it's an old song.
Okay.
It's goes like this. I'm not going to sing it. I'm going to say the words. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles, no rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses. And hippopotamuses like me, too.
That is so funny.
But I remember that all my life.
Oh, that
and a little girl sang it. I think her name was Gayla Marie. And I've never heard her sing anything else. I don't know what happened to her.
All right, that's so funny. I don't know how in the world I missed it, but I did. Dot, I appreciate
okay.
it. You
Thank
take
you.
Care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255, just in time for Christmas. Another three-book package, gang. Nothing neat about seeing your feet. Who cares about apathy and weirdos, winos, and defrocked priests? All three of those books for $34. And if you hurry, we're going to send all this stuff out priority mail, so maybe we can get this back to you by Christmas if we get it this week. Ludlow Porch, Post Office Box 1804, Fayetteville, Georgia, 30214. That's Ludlow Porch, Post Office Box 1804, Fayetteville, Georgia, 30214. Now, if your local bookstore is out of my new book, Who Cares About Boomy, I've got some of those now. So they're $22. That includes postage and handling. Just indicate in there who you want it autographed to and that sort of thing, and we'll get them right back to you. Ludlow Porch, Post Office Box 1804, Fayetteville, Georgia, 30214. $34 for the three-book set or $22 for the new book. All that includes postage and handling. And it is priority mail, so we'll get it back to you. Listen, we had a good time today, and I think we may have learned more about Wonder Woman than we ever wanted to know. But we'll be right back with you tomorrow, same time on your same local radio station. And did I say that? I said, who cares about Boomy? No, it's who cares about apathy. You're sitting on Boomy. If you just put Boomy, I'll know what it means. Who cares about Boomy? Everybody. Right back with you in the morning between 9 and whatever else you do today. You find somebody to be nice to.
with news at the top and bottom of every hour. You're never more than 30 minutes away from the most up-to-date information on News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens.
Good afternoon. I'm Mark Ailewine, and this is the Athens Noon Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. We have sunny skies, 49 degrees on South Village Avenue.
I'm meteorologist Mark Tobin. Your official three-day forecast is coming up on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Some of the stories we're following for you this afternoon. Closing arguments are underway in the second Oklahoma City bombing trial. A Northeast Georgia district attorney is turning in his law license. Plus,
the new police chief in Auburn is wasting no time in rebuilding the Barrow County Town's police department. This is WRFC's Indra Sybil. That story's coming up on the Athens Noon Update.
I'm David Johnston with sports. The Georgia men's basketball team now ranked number 20 in the nation, and the women escaped yesterday with a victory at Oral Roberts.
Taking a look at Wall Street at this hour, the Dow Jones Industrial Average is up about 45 points, the NASDAQ Composite Index down 16 points, and the S&P 500 is up almost 4 points. Now the latest news from ABC as the Athens Noon Update continues from News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
From ABC News, I'm John Belmont. Closing arguments underway at the Terry Nichols trial in Denver. ABC's John Bascom is there covering the finale of the second Oklahoma City bombing case.
John, the government will be hammering home its deeply involved in the bomb plot, side by side every step of the way with Timothy McVeigh, and as such is guilty of a capital offense, even though he was not in Oklahoma City when the bombing occurred. The defense will argue Nichols did not help make the bomb and did not help McVeigh park his getaway car just days before the blast. John
Bascom outside the federal courthouse in Denver. Arkansas State Police indicate no one else is in danger because of the school shooter still on the loose after a sniper attack this morning. Two students were shot in the parking lot of Stamps High School in southern Arkansas.
Wounds are in the buttocks area.
A hospital spokeswoman saying the students are not seriously hurt. Police hint the shooter in the nearby woods was targeting just those two and no one else. The new president of Iran is talking nicely about the U.S., defusing the incendiary rhetoric of the hostage crisis days. And President Clinton this morning returned the favor.
I would like nothing better than to have a dialogue with Iran, as long as we can have an honest discussion of all the relevant issues.
He spent the weekend rapping, now gets set to stand in line at the post office on the busiest mailing day of the year.
Packages, letters, and cards. Lots and lots of cards. Robert Munoz is pretty typical. He's set up a miniature assembly line on a tabletop to stamp all his cards.
I have about 40 here, and I have several more to go yet, and there may be another 2 or 3 days before I get it all in.
Munoz says he's just grateful for self-adhesive stamps. Less wear and tear on the tongue than in years past. Jim Ryan, ABC News, Dallas.
President Clinton this hour is expected to name Bill Land Lee, the nation's civil rights chief, over strong Republican. Listening to ABC News.
These days, no matter how cool the theme, most holiday parties are as flat as their chips.
Welcome to the Coalition Against Fruitcake Holiday Bash.
Next time, invite Red Lobster's party platters and make it a blowout, because no one serves up fresher seafood party platters, like our premium colossal shrimp platter, guaranteed to be the life of your next party, no matter what kind you're throwing.
Won't you look at the time? I've got to go.
Oh, stay a little. Here, have a chip.
Dive into Red Lobster's party platters and keep it jumping, because life on land is dry.
I love the holidays. It makes me happy, and it makes my customers happy.
You'll always find postal clerk Gracie Merriman in the holiday spirit.
Mostly during the holidays, I send packages. And they always want to know, well, when is it going to get there? When is it going to get there?
In about 2 to 3 days with price. $3.
Perfect for gifts.
The U.S. Postal Service. The holidays are here, and we're here to help.
I think I'm a child at heart. You never get too old.
If you're willing to pay more for organic foods, wouldn't you like to be sure the stuff you're getting really is pesticide and chemical-free? The feds are making their first move to help.
It's a $3.5 billion a year industry involving an estimated 12,000 organic farmers. But until today's action by the Agriculture Department, the industry has been subjected to no uniform national standards. Officials are now proposing that raw organic foods be without the use of pesticides or synthetic chemicals. And processed organic foods would have to contain 95% pure organic ABC News at the Agriculture Department in Washington.
Today's action deliberately avoids saying whether irradiated or genetically altered foods can qualify as organic. The Agriculture Secretary says that's still open to public debate. A California woman goes on trial today in the death of her 680-pound daughter. When officials found the 13-year-old's body last year, it was surrounded by fast food packages and her own waste. The mother pleaded innocent to neglect. The Supreme Court has dismissed the case of a Massachusetts woman who says her boss demoted her because she refused to attend a religious seminar. Lower courts ruled she couldn't claim discrimination because she didn't show the non-denominational seminar conflicted with her own beliefs. Wall Street, the Dow is up 41. This is ABC News.
Now you can whiten your teeth up to 7 shades in 7 days, guaranteed. How? With a natural white tooth whitening system, a unique 3-step system proven to safely whiten teeth up to 7 days. It's easy, safe, and takes just minutes a day at home. Nothing whitens teeth like a natural white system. Then, to keep your teeth their whitest, brush with natural white whitening toothpaste every day. Natural white, we guarantee whiter teeth.
For the ABC Information Network, I'm John Belmont.
And good afternoon. I'm Mark Alamine. This is the Athens Noon Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. We have sunny skies, 49 degrees on South Millage Avenue. The official three-day forecast from meteorologist Mark Tobin is coming up. Also on the way in this half hour, sports with David Johnston. Rob Orchard has the stock report from A.G. Edwards & Sons. It's Paul Harvey News and Comment, plus Channel 2 Action News. But first, the top stories from Athens and Northeast Georgia for Monday, December 15th, 1997. A power outage this morning caused problems on the University of Georgia campus. UGA spokesman Tom Jackson tells WRFC an early morning car wreck caused the power to be knocked out.
University police reported there was a traffic accident about 3 a.m. in which a car hit one of those green boxes, like an electrical transformer box, near Tucker Hall, and it knocked out a large portion of campus out of electricity, an area extending from Gilbert Health Center and New College all the way down through Tucker Hall and the steam plant.
Right now, all power has been restored except at Tucker Hall and the steam plant. Jackson says it will be most of the day before those two get power back on. The steam plant is burning on a backup generator. UGA Police Chief Chuck Horton tells WRFC the accident is still under investigation. The driver of the car was not at the accident scene when officers arrived. Well, Auburn Police Chief Bill Lewis is hiring officers to rebuild his department less than a year after it was dissolved by the Auburn City Council. WRFC's Indra Sybil has that story.
The 44-year-old Lewis has been doing mostly administrative duties. He's made one hire and hopes to have another three or four officers in place by next week. On December 4th, the Auburn City Council chose Lewis to rebuild the department it dissolved in February. After February's council decision, unhappy residents petitioned for an amended city charter requiring a police department. The new charter passed 3-1 in a September special election. Lewis says burglaries in the Barrow County town have increased since February because criminals knew it had no police force. In the newsroom, Indra Sybil, News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
WRFC news time is 12:07. A group of Clark Central High School teachers has sent a letter to Superintendent Dr. Lucian Harris asking him for help. This after two teachers and two administrators were injured following a fight between students at the school last week. Published reports say the letter asks Dr. Harris to help improve what they call an unsafe environment. The students that were involved in that particular fight have been suspended for school for 10 days and may face further disciplinary action. Well, an Athens man is facing charges after exposing himself at an Athens nightclub over the weekend. Authorities say 29-year-old Charles Lever showed his penis to around 15 people at the Country Rock on Commerce Road. He's been charged with indecent exposure. All county authorities have made an arrest in a 10-year-old custody case. WRFC's Beth Larson with that story.
Hall County Sheriff Bob Vass says a mother that fled with her daughter after custody was awarded to the girl's father in Texas 10 years ago was arrested Friday in Gainesville. Barbara McBride and her daughter Samantha had been living near Gainesville for the past 5 years. The two were going by the aliases Barbara and Penny Shelby. McBride has been working for a trucking company and Samantha was enrolled in high school. McBride is being held in the Hall County Detention Center awaiting an extradition hearing. Her daughter Samantha was taken into custody as a juvenile. Samantha was 3 years old when a judge awarded custody to her father. In the newsroom, I'm Beth Larson, News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
And a prosecutor in Northeast Georgia has offered to suspend his law license for 2 years. The state alleges that District Attorney Albert Taylor used money from a client's estate to pay for a $375 shopping spree. Taylor's judicial circuit, the Anoda Circuit, includes Lumpkin, White, Union, and Towns counties in the Northeast Georgia mountains. News Radio 960, WRFC News Time is 12:09. The Athens Noon Update continues now with the official three-day forecast. Here's meteorologist Mark Tobin.
Plenty of sunshine as we go through the afternoon hours. We'll have a breeze at times and a high of 54 degrees. Then cold tonight with a moonlit sky, low near 30. Tomorrow and Wednesday, mostly sunny skies each day. It'll be milder with pleasant afternoons each day as well. High tomorrow near 60, Wednesday's high 62. I'm meteorologist Mark Tobin with the official three-day forecast on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
And currently we have sunny skies. It is 51 degrees on South Millage Avenue. This weather forecast brought to you by First American Bank on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
This is Art Bell.
I began hearing a voice inside my head, a voice inside my head.
It's a pretty fine line there, Carol, when people begin hearing voices in their heads. Doctors usually begin prescribing medication.
Art Bell.
The voice inside my head.
7 nights a week, starting at 1 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
The friendly family bank, serving you since 1928. First American Bank and Trust.
Thinking about what to do with your estate? Hello, this is Jimmy Dudley with First American Bank. We would like to introduce you to our five-star trust services from First American. We offer a variety of trust services, including living trust, asset management, custodial securities, and estate administration. All of our decisions are made locally, not in New York, Atlanta, Charlotte, or elsewhere. We provide impartial, professional investment management of your assets in a manner consistent with your objectives and still give you the personal type of treatment you come to expect with hometown banking at First American Bank and Trust Company. Come by and see Emery Lewis, Janie Cooley, or Jane Blue. They'll be glad to help you. If it's a matter of trust, ask us.